Aloha everybody, this is Beth of Cooking and Crafting. Today I'm making a fresh fruit and custard tart with fresh strawberries on there. I am doing this as a collaboration with Ala. She is of Ala's Yummy Foods. Please see the link in the description box below, and I'll have a link to her beautiful no-bake caramel cheesecake tart that she's making. I met Ala at VidCon this year. She lives in the UK, but she specializes in Latvian, Russian, and Eastern European foods. Make sure you go check her out and subscribe and watch some of her yummy, yummy goodies. We're gonna start with 1 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour. Into that, we are going to cut. You can use a food processor for this, or two knives if you don't have a pastry blender. So into that we're gonna give half of a cup of cold butter that has been cut into small pieces, and we're just gonna blend this until it resembles coarse crumbs. To this I am going to add 3 tablespoons of cold water. I'm using my cute little Russian doll measuring spoons in honor of Ala. 2 3 tablespoons, and I zested 1 lemon and came up with about 1/2 teaspoon of lemon zest, and then I went ahead and squeezed that lemon and 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, fresh lemon juice, and I'm just gonna stir this together until I get my crust. I'm going to put the crust into my tart and tart pan here, and then we are going to place it into the freezer. If you find it easier, you can go ahead and press your dough between 2 wax papers and freeze it until it's easy to roll out, and then you can place it into the tart, but I find that's more a little bit more time consuming, so we're just gonna go ahead and, you know, press it in to the pan. It doesn't stick very much. If it does, all you have to do is just lightly wet your hand and nothing will stick to your fingers then. So now we're gonna place this into the freezer and allow it to freeze for about 20 to 30 minutes. About 25 minutes into that, you wanna go ahead and start preheating your oven to 425 degrees. But I want to make sure that I snugly place this foil into this pan. And what we're gonna do is we're going to bake this for 12 to 15 minutes until the crust is just set and beginning to brown. And then we're gonna remove the foil and continue baking for another 10 to 12 minutes. I have in this pan, I'm going to be placing 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, 3/4 cup of granulated sugar, and 1/8 teaspoon of salt. And we are going to mix this together, and then I am going to whisk in 2 cups of milk, and we're going to bring this to a gentle boil over medium-high heat. So once this comes to a boil, we are going to constantly whisk this for about 4 to 5 minutes until it's nice and thick. You want to take about 1 cup or so of this, and you want to gradually whisk this into your eggs, and you want to do it so that the eggs don't scramble. Now we will throw this back into the pot. All right, so constantly whisking. We're gonna add this in and cook it for another 2 to 3 minutes. And at that time, my first baking of the pastry will be complete. And I'll take off the foil. Turned off the stove. I'm now going to be adding 2 tablespoons of Challenge brand butter that's been cut into small pieces, along with 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla. We're gonna whisk that in until the butter is all melted. And then we are going to strain this over the a medium-sized bowl and let the custard set. I'm gonna strain this through a sieve. Put this through the sieve. We're going to place plastic wrap right onto the top of this. And we're going to allow that to sit for 1 hour in the refrigerator. So we'll get the plastic wrap. We will place it directly on and put it into the refrigerator. And I forgot to tell you before I put my tart pan into the oven that I, at 1-inch intervals, poked it with a fork so that it would bake evenly and stuff. And so I just cleaned almost two pounds of strawberries and sliced them nicely. And so now we're just gonna wait for everything to cool down and we're gonna throw it together. So I zapped a quarter of a cup of apricot preserves in the microwave for a couple of seconds, about 30 seconds. And I am taking the plastic off of the yummy smelling pudding or custard, whichever you want to call it. We are now going to scoop that in there and get us a level playing field here. Now that I have my strawberries on there, I am just going to glaze them with the apricot. And then you can put this in the refrigerator to chill until your guests have arrived. And it'll be very pretty ta-da moment when you bring it out. So nice and fresh and light. So there you go. My fresh fruit and custard tart with strawberries on here. I want to remind you to please make sure you go to Ala's channel and make sure you see her video with the no-bake caramel cheesecake tart that she's making. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. I do hope you go over to Ala's channel and subscribe to her and watch all of her yummy videos. Again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, please do so. I come out with videos every Monday and Thursday. By subscribing, you will be kept up to date with the videos that I come out with every week. And once again, thanks for watching. Bye.